All right, are we ready? So
don't strum it like that.
I won't strum it. Hey guys, I'm Maddie Sofia from NPR and Joe's Big Idea. We're here at the Smithsonian's Museum Support Center, and we are about to check out the largest collection of whale bones ever.
You could think of me as a marine mammal detective through geologic time. I look to the past to track down whale bones, to understand how whales came to be and where they're going. This is what I generally just call a whale warehouse. This is a place where we keep whale specimens, fossil from extinct species and modern ones from species that are alive today. And they're all under one roof. And that makes it a unique kind of place.
Why whales?
So why whales? I'm not a whale hugger.
Your socks would say otherwise.
Yeah, I got interested in whales because I thought they were fantastic vehicles to understand evolution. I think that's the job of any paleontologist, is trying to understand what happened in the history of life that we didn't see. We want to know those things, and it's a big detective story. How do we figure it out?
What do we got?
Whew, 15.7. So
big head, yeah. Bigger brain.
This happens to be the largest single specimen of blue whale jawbone that is in any museum, period.
Wow.
And consequently, because dinosaurs did not have a single bone that was larger than this one, these are the largest single osteological elements of any organism in the history of life on Earth.
That's amazing. Does that ever get lost on you?
No, it doesn't. It actually, you know, it kind of challenges me to think of the right scientific question to ask of this material. Because you could think about, well, how does a blue whale actually grow a bone this large? What are the physics involved with feeding with jaws this large? Those are all questions that can be investigated using these museum collections. We have, across all these shelves, the skulls of fossil whales. And I'm going to lift off the jacket just like this. I think it's tremendously cute.
Wow, it's crazy to think about how old these things are.
Yeah, right, and you can actually touch them, right? This is...
Can I touch them?
Yeah, well, you strummed a cast, so you might as well graduate to this level.
That's so awesome.
There's your time travel for the day.
It's like 11 million years old. I'm gonna touch it again.
Sure, go for it. That's gonna cost you. So again, this like imaginative process of looking into the Earth, into past snapshots, those give us clues about the potential future states of where we're heading. And I also think that that's something that we still control. We don't know how the future is going to shake out. We do know that these systems are dynamic and complex and can respond abruptly. They can respond in ways that we can't foresee, but we are a part of it. I think of humans as being participants in this great experiment that we're undertaking. We just need to be more aware of that.
This is Madeline Sofia reporting from the mouth of a whale. Nick Pyenson, also here.
It's my day job, so it's not that big of a deal.
Everyday situation for him.